The Earth, born in fire, baptized by lightning, since before life's beginning, has been and is a fire planet. After years of aggressive fire suppression, every Forest Service employee needs to understand why prescribed fire is now becoming our most effective management tool in restoring and maintaining healthy and productive watersheds and forests. In fact, not all fires are bad. Many of our ecosystems are dependent on fire, and the effect of fire, its location and intensity, can be controlled through prescribed burning.
It's important that we as natural resource managers appreciate the role of fire, value the role of fire, and in fact put fire back into the ecosystems where it once was. I like to view fire as one of the cleansing agents of the forest, of the land, just like wind and water. The application of prescribed fire is actually a preventative tool against the catastrophic fires, for example, that occurred in Yellowstone in 1988. In fact, our best defense is to fight fire with fire. Only we want to fight the fire on our terms, a prescribed burn, a cool fire that reduces the fuels on the forest floor, that revitalizes the forest ecosystem. What we want to take a look at here on the Mark Twain National Forest is a prescribed burn, to take a look at the best science being applied on the land by some of the best experts in the country that work for the Forest Service.
Conducting a prescribed burn requires many people from many disciplines.
Houston, this is Marvin.
It also requires strict adherence to safety principles.
Lynn, our test bar is looking really good here. I think we're a go on this one. Have you got an updated forecast?
Established procedures and a great deal of coordination.
You're looking at 75 degrees, 30% humidity, and the winds are out of the south at about 14.
That's copy on that. Dave, take that torch and start around that west side, if you would.
I copy.
In most wildland ecologies, fire is as essential as water. It's necessary. After generations of putting out all fires, large and small, in our national forests, we have unwittingly added problems to nature's delicate balance. Problems like highly flammable fuels, dead twigs, leaves, and needles, and the small, overcrowded saplings that burst into flame and carry fire to the crowns of mature trees. They combine to make a catastrophic, super-hot fire that nothing can survive. Lack of fire also allows pests to thrive, weakening and killing even big trees, adding more fuel for forest-killing blaze. That's why we, the Forest Service, use carefully planned fire to help restore nature's balance.
One of the most difficult things about being a burning boss is really getting the desired effect that you want. Anyone can burn a patch of land, but to be able to do the burn and say, this is what we really wanted to accomplish, and to be able to say, you know, that the imprint that you've left there is going to be what you want for not just this year, but for years to come.
Prescribed fire is just that, prescribed.
Prescription is the type of weather that we want, the humidities that we want, the moisture that's in the fuels that we want. Everything has to be perfect now before we ignite a burn.
The real advantage of a cool burn is it really reduces the fuel load, so when we do have a fire, it's not a catastrophic event. We're going from a time, say 70 or 80 years ago, where we thought all fire was bad. We've really seen fire as a friend today and how it can restore our ecosystems. But another change has been the need to integrate and work with local communities to make sure that they understand why the application of prescribed fire is important.
Reducing the amount of natural fuel in the forests can, in some circumstances, help reduce the threat of catastrophic fires that have the potential to wreak havoc in adjacent property. But the Forest Service cannot achieve this alone. We must work with local people to gain acceptance and support for prescribed burning.
I take that as a challenge for this agency. It's not only to go out there and to act as the people that have all the answers, but to get in touch with the communities and the influencers out there so that they can influence other people.
Getting the word out to the public is always an important step in planning for a prescribed burn.
Jody Eberly with the Forest Service over at Rolla. And tomorrow we're planning on conducting about 4 prescribed burns over on the Houston Rolla District.
As we get more of our publics moving into the rural areas, we have more of a health concern. For instance, a child with asthma may be very allergic to smoke. We need to know about that, and we need to balance what we're doing for our natural resources and how it affects the health of our publics.
These and other concerns are all weighed during the planning of a prescribed fire, but the most important considerations are safety and outcomes.
It'll take more than one burn to really treat some of this hardwood the way it needs to be treated. But we've met our objective here of fuel reduction. We've met our objective here for wildlife in terms of opening some things up and reducing those really thick brushy patches.
Now this burn is only about 3 weeks old, and you can tell here where we've got a lot of green vegetation coming back. You can hardly tell that it's been burned here unless you just pull this back and take a look at it.
Well, there's still some of the duff left here, and really good protection of the topsoil here, so we won't have any erosion. It looks like a really good job to me. That leaf litter layer and the organic soils below are just like a sponge, sopping that water up and keeping it on the land longer is the objective. And by restoring the functions of the watershed through the use of prescribed fires, the way we do that.
When we have to worry about water, it's not just the water that you can see, it's water that's underground that provides a lot of drinking water for most of our rural communities.
75% of the recreation that occurs in the United States occurs within a quarter of a mile of water, of the coast, a lake, or a stream.
And a lot of animal activity takes place within that quarter mile of the water also. We need to think about our activities in terms of making sure that riparian area right next to the water is protected and is available for all those critters that like to use it either permanently or on their way to and from other places.
We've actually planned some burns in and around rec areas to increase the opportunities for berry picking, to increase the opportunities for wildlife viewing because we've got the increased forage and a greater viewing distance.
We have several examples of glade communities on this forest where we burn them and the prairie wildflowers come back just gangbusters, and people driving by are just astounded when they see that kind of color, and it's really nice visually to be able to have that variety on the forest.
We need to take a look at forest management and all land management for the long term. We want to make sure that our watersheds are functioning, that we have clean water, recreation opportunities, healthy forests for future generations. Prescribed fire is important. It's one of the many tools that we apply in managing the land that belongs to all of the people.